Welcome to Mondulkiri in northeastern Cambodia. This is the largest but also most sparsely populated province, which makes for a great nature escape. This week, we take you into the wild, into the highlands of Cambodia. And in our guidebook that I was reading on the way here, I saw Mondulkiri described as the Switzerland of Cambodia. I don't know if there's much truth to that. I can reassess. Towards the end of the week, we expect to see Cambodian indigenous tribes, wildlife. We came here particularly to see the Cambodian elephants. We'll also see some waterfalls and do some trekking. And we'll start bright and early tomorrow. Hello, Bong. So when you come to Mondulkiri, you will most likely start right here in Sen Monorom, a small town of 10,000 people. We just did a full tour of the town by tuk-tuk. There's a nice pagoda, a lake, and from here you can access all kinds of high-end and lower-end resorts. We're staying in Gibbons, $15 a night.
Welcome to the magnificent hut.
Double bed, the essentials.
It's a really big bathroom.
And there's this inescapable but faint sound of Cambodian karaoke. And there's also a number of nice restaurants. We recommend Mondulkiri Pizza or Italian-style pizza and great service, as well as the Hangout for Western and Khmer food. Now that you know where to sleep and eat, let's get to the exciting stuff. It's day two. Today we've got an exciting day ahead. We're going out to see the Cambodian elephants this morning. And we're off. We hopped in a pickup truck and headed towards Mondulkiri Project, one of several elephant sanctuaries. I recommend this one or Elephant Valley Project. So we're approaching Mondulkiri Project, which is a 100% Cambodian-owned NGO that supports the rescue and protection of the local elephants. And a lot of funds also go towards supporting the Bnong tribe, which we'll get to see later today. So we're now walking in the jungle with our bananas to meet three elephants. There's Happy, Princess, and Gombin, and they all have a different life story, at least before arriving here. And so these elephants are still a little bit traumatized from their past. So we come in peace with bananas, which helps build a bit of trust and a better relationship with humans. So that behind me is Princess. She's 50 years old and used to work in tourism, pulling people around. People would sit on her back. So again, back-breaking work. And then over here we have Gambien, Princess's best friend, who also worked in tourism and was rescued in 2015. That was a really nice experience. It was really interesting to see how each of the elephants really had its own personality depending on his past and just general demeanor. And they're off to eat some bamboo, we're off to eat some lunch. We then went for a delicious traditional Bunong lunch, and in the afternoon we went for a swim with one of the elephants. I think this is the moment we go swimming with the elephants. Yeah, really quite a special experience. And from the water, you have to look up at these huge animals. It's really, really special. That's it for the elephant tour. Duong, our guide, then showed us how to make bird calls with nothing more than a leaf. And then we trekked back to camp.
Ah! Wow, that's amazing!
We then spent the night at this sanctuary, sleeping in hammocks and learning to make traditional Bunong bamboo soup, a local Bunong recipe that uses all organic ingredients and utensils, such as a bamboo stick as a pot. And I have a link to a video showing the recipe up above.
Let's see. Whoa!
And believe me, it is certainly more tasty than it looks. It has a bit of a roasted bamboo flavor, and you can top it off with some Bunong rice wine, aka happy water, which is also served in bamboo cups.
Salud!
Salud!
Salud! Good morning.
Good morning!
Today, the plan is to go on a big trek. We'll go some 19 kilometers into the forest, into the jungles.
So we're off on our trek to three waterfalls and then to Putang village with our machete equipped guide. And Samon, you will swim in a waterfall?
Yeah.
Yeah?
You okay?
Yes.
My everyday, like swimming the waterfall.
Every day?
Yeah.
Ah. I foresee 6 hours of small talk. We trekked up and out of the elephant sanctuary through the jungle.
And that right there is where we were sleeping.
We continued on to higher land where, unfortunately, much of the forested land is now gone.
This area that surrounds me, just 2 years ago, at the onset of COVID, was all part of the jungle. However, since tourism ceased to come, they really sped up the deforestation of this area, and the reasons are the wood has economic value, and then once deforested, whether legal or illegal, the land can be made arable for various cash crops. We saw some banana plantations, cashew plantations, and rubber plantations.
Anyway, I made a documentary style video on this topic called The Last Elephants of Cambodia, link up above. Now back to the trek.
We veered off the deforested hilltops and we're now back in the jungle, as you can see, and we're surrounded by bamboo, thick bamboo. See, I haven't been very impressed so far with any of the Cambodian waterfalls we have seen in the other provinces. Oh wow, water is definitely falling. And by the looks of our guide, I think we're going swimming. He's taken off his machete, he's good to go.
After a refreshing dip in the waterfall, we continued our trek to another smaller waterfall where we took our lunch break.
Okay, we've moved on to another waterfall, slightly smaller, and we'll have a little lunch break here.
Romantic.
Romantic.
Hey.
This whole little space is just beautiful.
Majestical.
He's clearing a path for us. And honestly, quite impressed. They know the jungle like the back of their hand. So this is the grandmother, and these two are her sons. He took us to one more waterfall. This one's ever so unusual. Wow, what a surprise. On very few occasions in my life have we stumbled across an elephant while hiking.
Hungry, it's up and mel.
Let's go up inland. We're taking a detour because it's apparently not a good sign to see a male elephant alone and potentially hungry.
Okay.
I think we all underestimated what 19 kilometers through the jungle feels like.
Okay, last hill. You can do it.
This is last hill?
More.
Okay, last one, but more.
Oh, hey, either way, it's beautiful up here. This day has felt really long, but I suppose that's because there's been so many little rich moments.
That's it for part one for the first 3 days of our trip to Mundulkiri. Stay tuned for part two, where we spent a day living with the Bunong tribe and learning all about their culture and ways of living. And we even had quite a wild rice wine infused night in the local shop, where I had the opportunity to ask them the all important question.
Can I ask you, what is important for a happy life?
I'm Conrad Richardson, and this is province number 8 of the Cambodia Travel Series. Do consider checking out the channel to see videos from other Cambodian provinces.